Hey guys, fellow Youmuus here, and today I'm gonna give you guys some tips that I've learned during my climb to Masters here, and these will for sure help you. You probably noticed, if you watched all of my Road to Masters Cup series, you probably know a lot of this stuff already, right? But for those of you who haven't watched every single episode, every single game, here are some refreshers. Let's get a little bit of honesty out of the way first. I am not Masters yet, even though I'm probably clickbaited it with something with Masters. But realistically, I am a Masters player. I'm not trying to be cocky, but I am Ultra Class 4 right now. I am Ultra Class 4 with 3 gems, 395 performance points, and let's see, where is my battle record? And I've been winning like every game solo, okay? Realistically, I am a Masters player. It's just I'm saving... you know, I'm not playing games right now and I'm not getting Masters because I'm saving it for a Road to Masters. I'm filming this video first, and after I film this video, I'm gonna film the Road to Masters and probably get Masters. So depending on when you watch this, I probably am Master, but currently I'm technically not Master yet. So let's go ahead and go into some practice tools, and then I'll give you guys some of the tips here. These, I feel like, some of them you guys probably know. You probably don't know all of them, and if you know all of them, you guys are probably pretty highly rated already. But here we go. First up is jump pad usage, okay? Jump pad usage, I have this written down as jump pad usage slash leaving base. Early game, you gotta remember to always use your movement ability when leaving base. Let's go ahead and load it up here. Alright. And this is very important because this is a short game, okay? Even in other MOBAs, champions with mobility will make sure to use their mobility when leaving base. Alright, so let me go ahead and fully level here. Alright. Even in other MOBAs, people will use their abilities to go ahead and leave base. But in this one, it's especially useful because every second matters, okay? And it's only a 10-minute game. So every time you're leaving base, I'm personally going to use Garchomp, my example, but other characters have mobility too. Every time I respawn or recall, I immediately Dragon Rush out. Dragon Rush out, and then I touch my center goal because it gives me move speed. And whatever lane I'm going to, I touch all the goals because it gives me move speed. This will get you back into lane the quickest and ensure that you are on the map for the longest amount of time. And then next tip here is late game, use jump pad really liberally. And I definitely do this myself. Late game, whenever I'm playing, I'm farming up, whatever. If I'm, for whatever reason, I'm half health or I'm a little bit chunked. On Garchomp, I don't even recall too much because I can heal. But most characters cannot heal. Because Garchomp, you know, if I'm fully stacked, I can heal, right? So sometimes I don't even recall, you know, as much as I should on other characters. So if you're even a little bit hurt, just go ahead and base, and then jump pad back out, and make sure you're as strong as possible for these Zapdos fights. Also, this is a major key. Huge one. Pay attention, guys, okay? If you guys are ahead, okay? If you know you're ahead, either you got Zapdos, or you scored a bunch of points, or you obviously have more goals than them, okay? These two outer ones, usually late game, in a fairly competitive match, these, both the outer ones at 2 minute, at the 2 minute point will be taken, okay? Both the outer one at the 2 minute point will be taken, and late game, everyone, even if they don't want it, they're carrying like 50 orbs. What you want to do to defend is not stand here. Do not stand here unless you have 5 members of your team alive. If you have 5 members of your team alive, sure, you can stand here, and then you have someone, you know, stand top right here, okay? If you have 5 members of the team alive, even then, you should only put 1 person on here and 1 person on bow. Because jump pad is so important. You're going to see this in a lot of my games, and in high elo a lot. Whenever the game is winding down, and the team that's ahead, what they're going to do is they're going to all stack on the jump pad, and they're going to wait. They're gonna wait till they see you capturing, then they're gonna blast and interrupt you. This way, it's like you have 5 people at top and bottom at both times, okay? If you have 5 people on the jump pad, and then you see 2 go top, 2 go bottom, you can immediately jump pad top, jump pad bottom. And then if you have 5 people on jump pad, you see 5 people bottom, you can all jump pad bottom if you need. And another tip with this is don't immediately blast when you see someone. If you have a lot of teammates, you'll see this in higher elo. If you have a lot of teammates on the jump pad, wait till they jump first, and then you wait. And then see if they can handle it. If they can handle it, let them handle it and stay on the jump pad. This is because you don't want to immediately see someone bottom, and everyone immediately blows their load and jumps bottom. And then someone goes and scores top, and you don't have a jump pad anymore. So it's very important. Let your teammate jump first, or you jump first, all right? And your teammate is going to see what happens. And then, depending on that, if he can handle it, let him handle it. Do not jump bot. There's kills mean nothing in this game. There's no point in getting two more kills late game. Score is all that matters. And if you're ahead, all you want to do is preserve your lead, okay? I don't care if you have 3 score and the enemy has 2 score, okay? What that means is you just got to protect it. Well, that's a bad example. That's actually a really bad example because it's very easy to score 1 point late game. So if you know you have a sizable lead, and by sizable, I mean 100, right? And it's very, very easy to get a 100-point lead in the late game. Make sure to defend. If you're ahead, defend, okay? Now, this segues into Zapdos. Zapdos is the most jarring part of this game. Zapdos. You can be losing the entire game, okay? And have 0 points. But if your team gets Zapdos, you have a fighting chance. I'm not going to say you're immediately going to win, because if your team is like 2 or 3 levels behind, you might get Zapdos and just immediately get full killed, right? But Zapdos is super, super jarring, and most games are decided by Zapdos and how you play around Zapdos. So here are some good general tips on Zapdos. If you are ahead, do not do Zapdos. I know this will piss off some of you guys that play solo queue. I play solo as well, okay? And I try to use as many pings as possible. If we're ahead, I'm permanently spamming retreat, okay? I'm permanently spamming retreat, and then I'm not walking into the pit myself. If you walk into the pit and hit Zapdos, what is that going to tell your team in solo queue? That means, oh, okay, we're doing Zapdos. If we're ahead and we don't need to do Zapdos, you will see me nowhere near the pit, bro. I'm going to be around here, and I'm going to be over here zoning people, because that's our job. If you're ahead, just don't let them get Zapdos. Don't even risk it. Don't even do it, okay? Because if you do it, there's going to be a Cinderace ult flying in. Like, I played the game so many times where I know what happens, right? All right? If there's going to be a Cinderace ult flying in, boom, you're ahead 200-300 points from the early game, right? And immediately they triple score on you and you lose the game. Alright? So if you're ahead, for the love of God, do not start Zapdos. Do not do it until they are aced. If they are aced, then you can do it. Or they have 3 or 4 members dead, and whoever left alive is zonable. This is important too. If a Cinderace is left alive, you should not do it. If a Talonflame is left alive, you should not do it. Because these characters can have an ability that just flies in from here and deal a billion damage. Cinderace with their ultimate, Talonflame with their ultimate, Lucario with their Aura Sphere. So make sure if you're gonna do it with 3 to 4 people left on your team, which is smart, you know, sometimes you should do it, because if you secure it, that means the enemy cannot get it and there's no way they can win, right? Make sure the last person is zonable. Like, if it's an Eldegoss, last one left, right? Chances are Eldegoss is not gonna steal. Even better one, Slowbro. Slowbro definitely not gonna steal. Eldegoss might actually get a chance to steal when she ulties in and then, you know, does that move. But Slowbro definitely not stealing. And then this is flipped. If you are behind, if you know you're behind, and how you generally know you're behind is if the enemy has more goals than you. Say you lost this and this and on top and bottom, whatever, right? So you're really behind. And the enemy still has all their goals. You know you are behind. In that case, you have to cheese it. Personally, my champion does Zapdos extremely quick. So my personal preferred method of cheesing is I come to Zapdos. This is for Garchomp only, but you could, you know, if you have a team, you can try and everyone 5-man wait in this bush and try and immediately burst it and wait and look for ways to cheese it. On Garchomp, personally, at 205 or so before Zapdos spawns, I'm gonna go ahead and stack up my passive, okay? I'm gonna have 5 stacks. The second it spawns up, boom, I jump in, I attack it with 5 stacks. And usually I can kill Zapdos in like 7 to 8 seconds, with like, depending on my build, maybe 10 seconds and my levelage. And that's a really good way to cheese Zapdos. If they are not in position and, you know, they're, you know, messing around or something and they're just arriving, they can very easily just lose Zapdos there, all right? Crucial tip, if you're behind, you need Zapdos. And then it's up to the enemy to stop you at that point, you know? That's when you gotta cause havoc, fight, do whatever you gotta do. But if you're behind, you 100% need Zapdos. Also, saving ults for Zapdos every game. No questions asked, okay? Absolutely no questions. I don't care what happens. If it's 2 minutes and 30 seconds in the game, okay? You can get a pentakill, okay? You can kill their entire team, but if you waste ultimate, it does not matter. If you waste ultimate, you actually lost. Never ultimate. There's so many times Garchomp ult is extremely strong. I get a shield, I become unstoppable, all right? A lot of the times, I can get away from the situation if I ultimate. But I will not do it. I rather die at 2 minutes and 30 seconds. If I die at 2 minutes and 30 seconds, I respawn back up in 19 seconds or so. And I can blast back and I have ultimate for Zapdos fight. Alright? Even if I used ultimate to survive at 2 minutes and 30 seconds, it doesn't matter. Guys, deaths in this game do not matter. What matters is scoring, okay? And if you... I'd rather someone die the whole game, okay? Like, 10 deaths permanently feeding, and then be ready for Zapdos and not die for Zapdos, than someone that went flawless the whole game, no deaths, but they're not prepared and they're dead on Zapdos. And that is honestly true. Like, it is so important to save your ultimate for Zapdos at all costs. Literally at all costs. It doesn't matter. Like... I honestly can't think of a way it matters. Unless maybe your whole team has a bunch of points and then you for sure can kill them all with your ultimate, and then your team goes ahead and instantly breaks 2 goals. And then even then it's tough, because then you might lose Zapdos because you don't have ulties. And just because the enemy team ults, don't be stupid like them, okay? Save your ults for Zapdos. If they ult, that's better for you guys. You don't have to immediately match them. I see this a lot with Ninetales players. Like, someone ults, and then Ninetales is like, okay, they ulted. It's my turn to ult now and get a big shield. No, bro, just die. Just die and save your ult for the Zapdos fight. That's way more important. And then next tip for Zapdos, wow, 10 minutes gone already. But these are all very, very good tips, all right? Zoning is always better than bursting, all right? Unless it's someone with a global. So whenever you guys, this is when you're actually doing Zapdos, all right? If you're actually doing Zapdos and say you're ahead, you should always have someone come out and zone. I'd rather have a Slowbro or even me, one of the highest DPS, characters, Garchomp. If I get the opportunity to zone, I'm going to zone and let my team do Zapdos solo. I'd rather my team 3v0 Zapdos, as in 3 of my teammates are hitting Zapdos and none of their teams hitting Zapdos, than 4 people from my team hit Zapdos and 1 person on their team hit Zapdos. So when you have the opportunity, always zone. But keep in mind, some characters are not zonable. Talonflame, Lucario, alright? People with global ultimates are not zonable. So, like I said, keep that in mind whenever you're doing Zapdos with, you know, you gotta think about those characters. And if you need Zapdos and you can't just, you know, not do it, then try and burst it. At that point, try and burst it. If they have a Cinderace, Talonflame, or Lucario, then you just gotta try and burst it. Okay, next tip. These are all super banger tips, actually. Okay, let's load up another practice game so I can walk around and, you know, show you guys stuff. Dreadnaw. At the current moment in July 27th, right? Or whatever patch we're going to be at, or whatever patch cycle we're going to be at. Dreadnaw is the most important objective before Zapdos, okay? Early game, you're going to want to secure Dreadnaw at all costs, okay? If you're the jungler or central, you need to play around bottom and be bottom when Dreadnaw comes up, okay? Dreadnaw gives everyone on your team a level, basically. And chances are, if you can get 2 or 3 Dreadnaws in a game, you already won. You are super ahead. You're gonna have 2 or 3 levels on the enemy the whole game. So that's why Dreadnaw is super, super important, and you need to secure it. And Dreadnaw is better than scoring top, okay? Another thing, Dreadnaw is better than scoring top, okay? Dreadnaw is better than getting Rotom. I don't care if you get Rotom and then they get Dreadnought. It's not a good trade, okay? It's never a good trade. I don't care if you score 80 points. Even if you score 80 points top and you break top tower, okay? It is not worth Dreadnought, and I'll tell you why. So say you and your lane partner top score 40-40 apiece. You guys both get XP, okay? And then you get the top tower. Awesome. You get 80 points and you break top tower. Amazing, right? But the enemy team got Dreadnought. Their whole team got the same XP you just got. So 2 people on your team got XP from scoring, and 5 people on their team got XP and the shield. And chances are, if you have 2 top and they have 3 or 4 bot, they're gonna go ahead and get Dreadnought, have the level advantage on you, have that shield, and they're just gonna end up dying you bottom anyway and getting the gold right back. So it is never worth trading Rotom, it's never worth trading farm, score, it's never worth trading anything for Dreadnought. And you wanna make sure you are very ready for the said Dreadnought fight. Okay, what else? Yep, always play Rotom. Currently in the game, Rotom is always worse. Never trade anything for Dreadnought. If you can get 2 or 3 Dreadnoughts a game, your chances of winning are astronomically higher, because then you can choose what you want to do with Zapdos. Because if you're ahead, if you're ahead as in levels ahead, but behind on score, you can just force a fight in the enemy jungle. When you're 2 or 3 levels behind, especially me on Garchomp, if I'm 2 or 3 levels behind, I can literally go in the jungle here and start 1v5ing. And I will kill 2 or 3 people, actually, you know? And then that gives my team a lot of pressure to do the Zapdos and all that. So Dreadnought, super important. Next one, play around power spikes in your game. This is also huge for Dreadnought or anything, okay? If you know Dreadnought's coming up in 30 seconds, and you're two camps off of level 8, go ahead and get your level 8, man. Go ahead and farm up jungle, you know, steal your jungler's jungle, whatever, okay? People say that, like, it's a bad thing, like, it's a team game, you know? Like, if your jungler doesn't get the camp, you're gonna get the camp, you know? It's not like you guys are losing. If you're two camps off, just quickly get two camps and get ready and go down there and be ready for the Dreadnought fight. Be as strong as possible for Dreadnought fight. Same with Zapdos. If it's 4 minutes in, right, and I'm like halfway to level 11, I'm just gonna stop going into lanes. I'm gonna farm a bunch of jungle and I'm just gonna farm and be strong for Zapdos. People can go score their like 10, 15 points. I don't care. I'm not even gonna defend it. I'll let them score it, right? Because I'm focused on farming and I know that if I get level 13 or a level advantage on Zapdos, it is huge. As opposed to the little 15 points that, you know, you can get from scoring or whatever. So always be prepared for power spikes. And this also means being strong for fights as well. Being strong for fights, I have some notes here on the side, okay? That means if you guys are fighting, say, this is a very important one. If you guys are fighting for, say, Vespa Queen here, right? You guys know you guys can touch your base, right? Touch your base, get a shield, and look how long your shield lasts. You see your shield? Your shield lasts like 10 seconds. So if you know Vespa Queen is about to come up, go ahead and touch your base, and then fight. So this is very important on Garchomp or Gible as well, too. Because you're gonna get poked. You're gonna definitely get poked for being a melee. So I go ahead and I touch the base and I get a shield. And this makes sure that I'm as strong as possible for the fight that's coming up here. So that means have cooldowns, have eject button. And this one you probably don't even think about. You see the little shield on me? This is from Assault Vest. Make sure you wait for Assault Vest too. You know, where's Garchomp? So look, I'm gonna take some damage from this guy. Oh, this guy doesn't do special damage. I forgot. This guy doesn't do special damage. But say you're against a character that does special damage, right? And they knock off your assault vest shield. Just chill out. Wait back here and chill out and get your assault vest shield back. Touch your base. And now you have 2 shields and you're going to be really strong for this fight, you know? Which is going to be really sick. Also, another quick tip about staying on point is Citrus Berry. Citrus Berry, you should not get it all the time. Early game, I see people that take damage, they immediately run the Citrus Berry. You shouldn't do this. You should leave at least 1 Citrus Berry in case their jungler gums spot and dives you, in which this Citrus Berry plus eject button will make you survive almost any dive. If you're getting dove, you're really low, boom, immediately eject button into the Citrus Berry. Also, if it comes to laning, if you're ever disadvantaged in lane, either the enemy is ahead or your laner went to roam, all you gotta do is chill. Don't fight them. Don't fight for Vespa Queen middle. If you can steal it, right? But if you know, if you're 1v2 bot, just go ahead and secure your own farm, okay? And then go under tower. Secure your own farm, go under tower, and don't let them score. Don't let them get any more XP. And let your teammate that's roaming or whatever do their thing and get other lanes ahead. And just make sure you don't lose bot and stop the bleeding, okay? That's tip number 4. And final tip. This one's a little bit more vague, that's why I left it for last, okay? Is know your role, okay? Know what your character does and know what their job is. What I mean by this is, like, if you're Cinderace, right? Your role is to be a DPS and you're like a carry. You know, you let the front line walk in front and you DPS everyone. And you have to understand that role and use your abilities accordingly, okay? Use your abilities to DPS, use your abilities to secure. You know, like Cinderace has that ulti to help you secure Zapdos. Know your role. Know that you're supposed to secure Zapdos on your character here. Alright? And eject button. Since you're a carry, you're gonna get jumped on. You know you're gonna get jumped on. Save eject button to escape and peel for yourself. Instead of, you know, just like completely thirst down someone with 1 HP. If you see someone running away on HP and you can secure the kill with eject button, chase them for a bit. Make sure you can't kill them. Then think about eject button. And don't just immediately eject button. And then get the kill. Okay, cool. You eject button, then you kill the elder boss. Now, me, the Garchomp, can immediately jump on you, full combo you, and kill you. And then you might have just thrown the game here. they're characters like that, and then same with Snorlax. Like, know your role is to peel. Sometimes you have to eject button back and get a Garchomp off of your Cinderace, right? So my job in a fight as a Garchomp is to jump in the back line and be as big of a nuisance as possible. Disrupt them and do a huge amount of damage. So I know my role. That's what I'm saving eject button for. I'm not saving eject button to leave, you know, because I know my role is to jump in the back line, cause as much havoc as possible on their key targets. So that's why I'm saving my eject button for like my earthquake combo or like my ultimate eject button here. This is also very crucial on Garchomp. Your ultimate eject button, like that, you see that? That's huge. That will get a lot of people killed. And I'm saving my eject button for stuff like that. I'm not saving my eject button to run. My job in a fight is not to run and stay alive. My job in a fight is to cause havoc, do as much AoE damage as possible, all right? And once you know your role, your teammates are gonna love you, man. You're gonna do what your champion's meant for. You're gonna help carry a lot more games. That is going to be my last tip there. Kind of vague, but hopefully those tips help you climb. If you guys have anything else you guys think that would be helpful, make sure to leave in the comments below to help out some of the other people. Drop a like if you guys enjoyed. I thank you guys all for watching these videos. I really, really appreciate it. And I like that you guys enjoy my content. I'm spending a lot of time on it, and I really appreciate you guys. Drop a like, drop a comment. I read all the comments and reply to all the comments of any questions you guys have. Join the Discord if you guys want to talk to me personally, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye. Thank you guys for watching. Again, Zapdos. Play around it.